This is CS50's game development course assignment 8. In this assignment, we were given just two specifications to add to the game. In the first specification, we had to add gems to the game that spawn in much the same way as coins, though more rarely so. Gems should be worth 5 coins when collected and despawn when off the left edge of the screen. In order to do this, I've created two C# scripts, gem.cs and gemspawner.cs. Gem.cs basically is identical to coin.cs. Its x position goes less than minus 25, we destroy our game object. Else we just translate it according to the skyscraper speed and rotate it along the y axis. And in our onTrigger function, we just call the pickup gem function in our heli controller C# script. And then we destroy our gem object. In our helicontroller.cs, our pickup gem function, I've set a coin total to increment by 5. Which means that a gem has been picked up, and we play our audio source and particle system same as that of pickup coin. And in our gem spawner, we just start a coroutine which is the same as that in coin, except for on line number 29 in our yield return, I've just changed our random range to 6 from 6 to 10 in order to spawn gems less. Next, in the second specification, we had to fix the bug where the scroll speed of planes, coins, and buildings doesn't reset when the game is restored via the spacebar button. In this, we go to our game over text.cs, and in our update function on line number 34, just as soon as we press the spacebar button, I'm just restarting the sky, setting the skyscraper spawner.speed back to 10f. Which will just reinitialize the speed for all the objects in our game. That's it. I'll be showing a demonstration.